How about Regis, huh?
I know, your neighbor.
We lived in the same building.
Yeah.
I loved Regis. I mean, I would see Regis almost every day. And there he was, like the guy from television. He'd be standing there and he goes, Howard, Howard, it's me. It's Regis. How you doing, Howard? You're doing great. You're going out there. I saw you on Letterman the other night. You were terrific. I mean, that's the kind of guy he was.
That's what he was always like.
I remember one time, there's a gym right next door to our building. I see Regis walking into the building, and he's got on short shorts, like Richard Simmons short shorts, and a tank top. You know,
oh my Regis, God.
Yeah, a tank top, you know, with the hairy chest and the, and he goes, look at me. Can you believe what shape I'm in? Look. And he starts making muscles, and you had to be instantly in a good mood when you saw Regis. He was a really lovely man, from what I can tell, in the lobby. And we had some really good laughs together. I mean, we really did.
Yeah.
Here's a funny memory, and this involves Robin. So Robin was on Celebrity Edition of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. We devised a plan that she should bring a lifeline with her. And who did Robin bring as her lifeline? Remember Matt McGrory? He was the original Bigfoot on our show. He was 7.5 feet tall.
Wasn't I saying he was my love interest?
Yeah, you said your boyfriend. So Robin goes on with a straight face and says, I brought my boyfriend with me, Regis. There's Matt. And they cut to him in the audience, and this was 7 foot... guy.
Got Bigfoot standing there, sitting there right behind. Looks like he's standing, but he's sitting
intended,
right there.
Bigfoot.
How you doing, Bigfoot? Nice to see you.
29 and a half inch foot, Regis. And then he was a bouncer in a bar in Philly. Yeah, and he said, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to move to Los Angeles and become an actor.
And then what happened, Bigfoot?
then I went out and I started getting a couple of movie roles, and now apparently I'm engaged to Robin. I was unaware of that. And,
he was a nice guy, Bigfoot.
He was.
By the way, I should also mention Regis was David Letterman's most frequent guest. He was on Letterman 136
Letterman
times.
Letterman loved Regis, yeah.
Yeah. Letterman yesterday tweeted out that Regis was his best guest. He said once Regis left television, that he lost interest in being on television. Here's Regis on Letterman. Oh, this is pretty good. So the rumor was out there that Regis and Kelly Ripa didn't get along, and this is Regis on the Letterman show.
People say that there's trouble.
There's no trouble.
Well, I hear and I read and people tell me, oh did this and that and this
Absolutely.
And that.
She couldn't be happier.
Really? And how about you?
Me, I just plod along. You know what I mean? Who's ever there is there.
Well, now, with all due respect...
She's great. And let me tell you something. Last time she was here, I was supposed to drive her away.
Oh, and that's it, right.
Remember that last guy? And it began to rain.
It's raining outside, sure.
It began to rain. And all of a sudden, Regis is out there with a top down on a convertible getting soaked in this rain.
Oh, my God.
And you two were sitting in there, and I heard you say to her, let's just sit here, Kelly, and see how long it takes him to get mad. Remember that?
Yeah.
I came in drenched. I was out there like a farm animal in the rain.
Like a farm animal. In the rain, you poor thing.
That's pretty good appearance.
Yes, it is.
That's good. Top notch. Letterman's right.
Yeah.
Regis was a singer, too.
Goodbye to good times.
Goodbye to good times, Regis.
Hello to pain.
You're not kidding.
All my good loving.
And Regis, thank you for welcoming me into my building and being such a nice guy.
But you'll be sorry.
And my condolences to Joy, his wife, who's always very lovely to me also.
You're gonna miss me, the best thing you ever had.
I am gonna miss him.
The best thing the world ever had.
You're gonna need someone one of these days.